These Final Hours is not your usual dystopian end-of-the-world movie.
Is there anybody out there? It's happened. Approximate location of impact, the North Atlantic. As I speak to you right now, it's making its way towards our fair nation. We have 12 hours, people.
Written and directed by Western Australian Zach Hilditch, developed with producer Liz Kearney and executive producer Robert Connolly, what sets These Final Hours apart is that it's a little independent Australian feature film. It's no studio monster. At 2.5 million, it's not overloaded with CGI and special effects. It relies a whole lot more on character and performance. We follow James, Nathan Phillips, on the road to the planet's end over the final 12 hours. James leaves his pregnant lover to rage like there's no tomorrow with his girlfriend.
I hope you're looking after yourselves out there and each other. These are things we gotta hold on to.
But the bad boy's end of world party plans are turned on their head when he rescues Rose from the clutches of evil.
It's okay. Let's get out of here.
Writer-director Hilditch plays with science fiction and the road movie in a way obviously born of a love and respect for genre.
James.
My favourite science fiction films are ones like 28 Days Later, 12 Monkeys, Moon, smart science fiction films that take those genre tropes but throw them against a wall and really focus on the human condition, like tell a very personal tale within those confines. And this was my attempt to do one of those, to tell a really cool, interesting, multiplex film that an audience might find entertaining, but to really also make them feel and make them think and ultimately make them reflect on what they might do on the last day on Earth, as we all have our own answer.
Is this your answer?
Mine would involve friends and family and a lot of booze, but probably not the raucous nature of the end of the world party we see in the film.
Hey man, can you believe I thought no one was gonna come to my party, man? Just look at these fuckers, they're just going off, man. They're just, you know what I mean? They're going fucking... And they're just loving each other, man. They're just having life the way they want to have life with.
Where's Vicky?
Who the fuck are you?
Boy, where's Vicky?
Jesus, I don't know, fuck. She's just gonna be fucking somewhere.
You mentioned the human condition. What are you trying to say? Anything in particular about the human condition, where you think we are at this particular point in history and time?
Well, again, like, this is just my interpretation of how I feel in Perth, Western Australia, the last day on Earth, the last 12 hours of life on Earth might look and feel. The reason I decided to follow James as a character was turning 30 myself, you know, write what you know, like, I was experiencing those situations of, like, thinking that life might hold more than getting pissed with your mates every weekend and all those sort of mature, responsible things that you make when your brain makes that shift from 20 to 30. So I, you know, that was always the character that I wanted to follow. But I definitely wanted to look into that world and sort of, just explore that everyman tale where a man realizes he has more self-worth than he thought he might have had through the ultimate ticking clock, such as the last day on Earth.
You were a kid, James?
I came here because I didn't know what to do. I'm gonna take that girl back to where she belongs.
What about it? Where do you belong?
Dad always said that God has a perfect plan for everyone. Do you ever think you might end up in hell instead of heaven?
So it's a redemption story.
Totally, and the film basically explores that it's never too late to find redemption, even in the face of the apocalypse.
Even at the last minute.
Absolutely.
James's journey to redemption is built around relationships with his mother.
Help this girl.
Just trying to help her, Mum.
You better go.
His abandoned lover and his girlfriend.
How come you're not with her?
I've messed a lot of things up, Rose.
I'm still trying.
I just hope you're all keeping safe out there. You're surrounded by your families.
Hold on.
And most importantly, Rose. Three generations of women.
I've been surrounded by women my whole life. You know, I grew up with my sister and my mum. raises and let me watch a lot of television and movies, stuff that I probably should never have watched. So, you know, all these things were in my subconscious, and it just sort of came out of me when I was writing the script, that the people that he would have to bump into and the people that he would have to face just so happened to all be women. And it was never an intentional thing, but as I was figuring out what his journey needed to be, it just made perfect sense that he's having those women dramas in his life with the girlfriend and the mistress, and the last thing this guy needs is to look after a little girl. And like, I just thought that was just a more interesting way to sort of explore this rough and ready guy in this, you know, dark place on the last day on earth.
These Final Hours was picked up for national release at last year's Melbourne Film Festival. It opens on 160 screens, a huge release for such a small film, any filmmaker's dream.
Still pinching myself. I was just out yesterday on Parramatta Road looking at the gargantuan billboard that is erected up there. And it was one of those amazing moments where to see it physically as a part of the world, not just on the internet it was just, it's surreal. It's surreal to think that we were making this kind of film. Myself and Liz never thought we were making this kind of film. We thought, you know, art house, we're going to have to promote the living crap out of it, but when Village Roadshow came on board, it's just going to reach so many more people this way, and they've just been so supportive. It's pretty crazy.
So check it out. It's not perfect. There are a few holes here and there, but the performances are solid. The direction is actually quite good. The sound design is fantastic. It's certainly worth the price of a ticket. This has been Pete Castaldi. Till next time.